Welcome back, students. So we have started with matrices and we have done three classes already. So it's not a big chapter and the concepts are too less in this chapter. So this chapter is basically study about operations on matrices. What are the different operations we can perform on matrices? So we already studied we can perform addition on matrix, then we can do subtraction, then scalar multiplication, then we have something called as the most important one among all this is going to be this one. Okay, what is called as matrix multiplication, right? And the last thing what we studied was transpose of a matrix. This was our last topic. So based on this we have done few problems. I told you what is the meaning of transpose of a matrix. So given a matrix, when you interchange the rows and columns, the resultant matrix will be called as transpose of the given matrix. So if A is a matrix, so its transpose is denoted by this symbol. On this we have some standard properties. A plus B, the whole transpose can be written as A transpose plus B transpose. A minus B, the whole transpose equal to A transpose minus B transpose. But AB, the whole transpose is actually written as B transpose multiplied by A transpose. So these are some standard properties based on matrix transpose. So on this we have completed some worked examples also from NCERT. So today we are going to concentrate on the NCERT exercise problems based on the transpose of the matrix. Now in transpose we have some definitions actually. So what do you mean by symmetric matrix? What do you mean by skew symmetric matrix? So we have studied the symmetric condition already. A square matrix A is said to be symmetric if A is equal to A transpose. It is skew symmetric if A is equal to minus A transpose. This is one thing. So based on symmetric and skew symmetric, we have a property. A matrix can be written as sum of symmetric plus skew symmetric. I told you, for every matrix, A plus A transpose is symmetric, A minus A transpose is skew symmetric. Why this half is taken, I have explained you already. Okay, when I perform this, I should get back my matrix A. Simply if I add these two, I will not get matrix A. But if I take half of them, okay, and add it, the resultant will be equal to A. So this is one of the standard conditions we have to remember. Fine. So today let's concentrate on finishing the exercise problems based on transpose of the matrix. So in the transpose of the matrix, the first one, that's first main. So the first main, what they said is find the transpose of each of the following matrices. Quite simple. Okay, first matrix, I wanted to just give a name when solving this problem. So 5 1 by 2 minus 1, this is the matrix. So its transpose is given by 5 1 by 2 minus 1. Whatever is there in row or column, the same thing has to be written in row. That's it. Now the second one. Now matrix A is given as 1, minus 1, 2, 3. So its transpose is denoted by this symbol. So the rows should be written as columns. So 1, minus 1, 2, 3. So close it. That's the transpose. So number 3, we have a matrix which is given by minus 1, 5, 6, root 3, 5, 6, 2, 3, minus 1. This is the matrix. So its transpose is given as, now either you convert all the columns to rows or all the rows to columns, the other one will be done automatically. So if I write this rows in terms of columns, so minus 1, 5, 6, root 3, 5, 6, and the next one is 6, 6, minus 1. Fine. So that's how the transpose of the matrix should be done. Now the next, based on the properties of transpose, second column, matrix A and matrix B are given. So we have to verify the first one, and the first one we have to verify A plus B, the whole transpose equal to A transpose plus B transpose. So let us find LHS and RHS separately and check this. So the condition is, first is A plus B, we perform A plus B. So there are two matrix A and B given. Let's add these two. So on adding this, so it's going to be minus 5, 3 and minus 2. Now the next is going to be 6, 9, 9, and the last one, minus 1, 4, 2. this is a plus b. Now write the transpose of this actually now. So this should be a plus b, the whole transpose equal to minus 5, 3, minus 2. First row is written as first column, then 6, 9, 9. Second row is written as second column, minus 1, 4, 2. Third row is written as third column. This is a plus b, the whole transpose. Now to find the RHS, a transpose plus b transpose. A matrix A is given there. So let's find its transpose. Minus 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9, minus 2, 1, 1, plus B transpose, minus 1, 4, minus 5, 1, 2, 0, then 1, 3, 1. This is A transpose plus B transpose. So let's add these two. So I'm adding these two. So if I add this, it's going to be minus 5, the next one is 6, and the next one is minus 1. Now let's add up the next. So it's going to be 3, 9, 3. Sorry, 3, 9, 4. Now the next one, if I add it, so it's minus 2, 9 and 2. And check LHS and RHS, both are one and the same, fine. So what I will write here, therefore A plus B, the whole transpose, can be written as A transpose plus B transpose. It is so simple topic actually, okay. The chapter itself is easier one. Not to say topics actually, the chapter is one of the easiest chapter where you can score very easily without using much, it's not much risk actually. Where is the risk in this chapter? Okay, it's just addition, subtraction, multiplication, if you know, that's enough, right? Okay, so in this, we have second one actually, so let me not do it. So what I will do here, in this the second one, what they have given us, A minus B, the whole transpose is A transpose minus B transpose. I hope now all of you are in this stage to just perform these things quite easily. So find out LHS and RHS separately. Find out A minus B and then its transpose. Find out A transpose, B transpose and subtract those two. And check LHS equal to RHS. That's all you should do. Okay. So that's how the second one can be done. And the same thing. With problem number 3, again the same two properties has to be checked. So problem number 3, the first, let us start with finding A plus B. So matrix A, the third one you have to be careful. Matrix A is not given to us directly. In the third column, they said A transpose to us. So what is A transpose is given as 3, 4, minus 1, 2, 0, 1. So from A transpose you write down A. That means the transpose of this once again. So what is that's going to be now? So 3, minus 1, 0, 4, 2, 1. And matrix B is given to us. What is matrix B is given as? Minus 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3. Clear? So let us start verifying the property. So we have A and B. So let's find out A plus B. A plus B is going to be addition of these two matrix. So it's going to be 2, 1, 1. And the next is going to be 5, 4, 4. This is A plus B. We want the transpose of this. So A plus B, the whole transpose can be written as 2, 1, 1, 5, 4, 4. That is done. That is LHS of the property. Then the next thing. We have to find something called as A transpose plus B transpose. A transpose, which is given there, or you can take the transpose of this. 3, minus 1, 0, 4, 2, 1. Plus B transpose, minus 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3. That's fine. Let's add up these two. So I'm adding this, 2, 5. So 1, 4, 1, 4. That's fine. And check the LHS and RHS, both are same. So after this, it's better you give some numbers like, for example, this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Then write properly, no? From 1 and 2. A plus B, the whole transpose can be written as A transpose plus B transpose. Okay, it has to be equal. And if you are not getting equal, then something is wrong. Some calculation you went wrong. That's all. Okay, so it's a standard property. A plus B, the whole transpose can be written as A transpose plus B transpose. In this, we have the second one. So what we have to do this time? Subtraction. So first, let us find out A minus B. Subtract these two. So 3 minus of minus 1, so that's going to be 4, minus 1, minus 2, that's minus 3, 0, minus 1, that's minus 1, that's fine. Now if you think that no sir, we are finding it difficult, write side by side no, and then subtract it. Okay, fine. Now it's going to be 4 minus 1, that's 3, 2, minus 2, 0, 1, minus 3, minus 2. This is A minus B. Take the transpose of this. A minus B, the whole transpose equal to 4, minus 3, minus 1, 3, 0, minus 2. Right? Similarly, let's find out A transpose minus B transpose. So A transpose is 3, minus 1, 0, 4, 2, 1. Minus B transpose, minus 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3. So let's subtract these two now. So on subtraction of these two, 3 minus of minus 1, that's 4. The next, 4 minus 1, that's 3. Next, minus 1 minus 2, that's minus 3. 2 minus 2, 0. Next, 0 minus 1, minus 1. 1 minus 3, that's minus 2. Right? So can we compare LHS and RHS to the property? So once again, we can write it. Therefore, A minus B the whole transpose can be written as A transpose minus B transpose. So a standard property based on transpose of the matrix. So let's have the next one. That's about problem number 3. So in problem number 4, so problem number 4 also they have given A transpose actually. So careful. You have to see the symbols carefully. Sometimes instead of giving the matrix, they will give you the transpose. So when transpose is given, you find the matrix and then continue. So A transpose is given as this. So therefore, matrix A is going to be minus 2, 1, 3, 2. Right. The transpose of this nothing but A. Right. Then we have given B. So B is given as minus 1, 0, 1, 2. Right. What we have to find? We have to find a matrix called as A plus B, the whole transpose. This is what we have to find. First, let us find out A plus 2B. So, A minus 2, 1, 3, 2 plus 2 times B minus 1, 0, 1, 2. So, let us simplify a bit. Minus 2, 1, 3, 2 plus 2 should be multiplied to each element. So, it's going to be what? Minus 2, 0, 2, 4. That's fine. Now just the addition of these two matrix now. So the addition of these two matrix, minus 2 minus 2, that's minus 4. 1 plus 0, that's going to be 1. 3 plus 2, 5. 2 plus 4, 6. This is A plus 2B. Take the transpose of this. Therefore, A plus 2B, the whole transpose equal to minus 4, 5, 1, 6. That's how it should be performed. Okay? I don't think any of the students is going to say, no, this is one of the toughest chapter, I'm unable to work, unable to understand. No, nothing. No reasons can be given. Okay. You cannot search an easier chapter more, and another easier chapter other than matrices actually. Okay. So fourth one is done. Let's move on to the next. Problem number 5. So a matrix A is given to us. 1, 4, 3. 1 minus 4, 3. And matrix B is minus 1, 2, 1. We have to verify the property AB the whole transpose equal to B transpose multiplied by A transpose. Correct now. So, first thing, I have to find LHS. In LHS, first find out AB, then its transpose. We have done one problem yesterday of this kind, if you remember. So, let's consider AB. 1, minus 4, 3. I told you why this problems will be given. To make you confused actually. Most of the students, even though it looks so simple, most of the students will go wrong. So you have to understand when multiplying, we will take it like this, right? First row, first column. So first row, first column, 1 multiplied by minus 1, minus 1, it's over, no plus, no minus. Because below this, there are no elements to continue, right? Next, first row, second column. This is first row and this is second column. So 1 multiplied by 2, it's a separate element now. So 1 multiplied by 1, that is 1. That's also a separate element. This is the reason. Most of the students, what they will do, they will put the plus sign. So it's going to be wrong then. Fine. So take care of this thing and let's continue. Now let's continue with second row. Minus 4 multiplied by minus 1. That's 4. Next, minus 8, minus 4. So let's continue with row 3. So it's going to be minus 3, 6, 3. This is AB. Take the transpose of this. AB the whole transpose equal to minus 1, 2, 1, 4, minus 8, minus 4, minus 3, 6, 3. Clear? Right. Now, to start with RHS, first B transpose multiplied by A transpose. B transpose is minus 1 to 1 multiplied by A transpose 1 minus 4 3. So the matrix multiplication remains the same, first row first column. So if on multiplying, so it's going to be minus 1 first row second column, that's 4, and the next one is minus 3. So let's continue with second row. So 2 multiplied by 1, 2, 2 multiplied by minus 4, minus 8, and then next element is going to be 6. The last row, 1, minus 4, 3. So that's my equation number 2, that's my equation number 1. Compare these two matrix. So what we will say, from 1 and 2, AB the whole transpose can be written as B transpose multiplied by A transpose. So it's easy to check the answer, and easy to get the answer also. So let's have the next one. Second problem in this, fifth means second one. In this, matrix A is given as 0, 1, 2, and matrix B is given as 1, 5, 7. Same thing we have to verify. AB the whole transpose equal to B transpose multiplied by A transpose. So let us start with AB. So 0, 1, 2. And that is multiplied by 1, 5, 7. So let's multiply. So first row, first column. So you can just check all the elements are going to be 0. Then the next 1, 5, 7. And the next 2, 10, 14. This is AB. Now let us take the transpose of this. So AB the whole transpose equal to 0, 0, 0, 1, 5, 7, 2, 10, 14. Let's call this as equation number 1. Now, to start with the right side, B transpose multiplied by A transpose, 1, 5, 7, multiplied by 0, 1, 2. That's okay? Fine. So, first row, first column, so it's going to be what? 0, 1, 2. Right, the next, 0, 5, 10. Then the next, 0, 7, 14. That's equation number 2. Since most of you are already familiar with matrix multiplication, I don't think you are finding anything difficult here. So this is going to be the RHS, this is LHS. Compare these two, both are same. So AB the whole transpose can be written as B transpose multiplied by A transpose. So fifth one we have finished. So let's have the next. In problem number 6, again two submains. So sixth one, first one, matrix A is cos alpha, sin alpha, minus sin alpha, cos alpha. So we have to show that A transpose multiplied by A. We have to verify A transpose multiplied by A is going to be I. So you know how to take the transpose of this. So A transpose multiplied by A, the transpose of this, correct now? So this should be cos alpha, sin alpha, minus sin alpha, cos alpha. This is A transpose multiplied by the matrix. So cos alpha sin alpha, and this is minus sin alpha cos alpha. Fine. So let us take the product of these two. So we'll go for multiplication. First row, first column. So cos alpha multiplied by cos alpha, cos square alpha, minus sin alpha plus sin square alpha. Correct? Right. The next, cos alpha multiplied by sin alpha, so retain cos alpha sin alpha, again if I multiply, minus cos alpha sin alpha. So let's go with the second row. So second row, on multiplying, sin alpha cos alpha minus sin alpha cos alpha, right? And the next one, if I multiply these two, so it's going to be sin square alpha plus cos square alpha. So what is sin square alpha plus cos square alpha? 1, and here the elements get cancelled, so it's going to be 1, 0, 0, 1. That is nothing but the identity matrix, correct, right? So A transpose into A should be equal to I. That's correct. I hope you can manage the next one, second one of the sixth main, same thing. So show that A transpose into A is equal to I, that you can manage. So I'm going to leave that. Let me explain you, seventh main, first one. A matrix is given to us, 1, minus 1, 5, then minus 1, 2, 1, then 5, 1, 3. We have to show that this is going to be a symmetric matrix. What's the condition for a symmetric matrix? A matrix is symmetric if A is equal to A transpose. This is matrix A. Let's find out its transpose. So what is A transpose will be? So rows will be written in column wise. So 1, minus 1, 5. Next, minus 1, 2, 1. Next, 5, 1, 3. Correct, right? This is A transpose. Just check now, A transpose and A, both are same. So, since A is equal to A transpose, therefore A is a symmetric matrix. That's all the conclusion you have to make. So a matrix is symmetric, a square matrix is symmetric if A is equal to A transpose. That's enough to say. In this second one is there. So a matrix is given to us 0, 1, minus 1, minus 1, 0, 1, 1, minus 1, 0. Show that this is a skew symmetric. What is the condition for skew symmetric? Skew symmetric condition, A is equal to minus A transpose. So first let us start with A transpose, the transpose of this matrix. So the transpose of this 0, 1, minus 1. Next minus 1, 0, 1. Next 1, minus 1, 0. This is A transpose. Multiply this with a negative sign. So minus A transpose equal to, each element will be multiplied by the negative sign. So 0, 1, minus 1, minus 1, 0, 1, 1, minus 1, 0. Right? Can I say this matrix and the one which is given to us both are equal? Of course, A what we got here is nothing but minus A transpose. Therefore, A is equal to minus A transpose. Therefore, A is a skew symmetric matrix. That's all the conclusion. Let's have the next one. Problem number 8. So in problem number 8, a matrix A is given as 1, 5, 6, 7. In this first one, we have to show that A plus A transpose is symmetric. Second one, we have to show that A minus A transpose is skew symmetric. Two conditions we have to verify. Clear? To verify the first one, what we have to do? We have to show that A plus A transpose is symmetric, right? So what I need to show, this is what I should show, right? If A is a matrix, A equal to A transpose. Here this time, this is the matrix, right? So A plus A transpose, this is the matrix. That should be equal to the transpose of this same matrix. So first let us find both the sides separately. So let us start with A plus A transpose. 1, 5, 6, 7 plus the transpose of this 1, 5, 6, 7, correct? So let's add up these two matrix. So it's going to be 2, 11, 11, 14. This is A plus A transpose. The transpose of this matrix, A plus A transpose, the whole transpose equal to 2. So whatever is there in row, I will write it as column, correct? Now the next one is 11, 14. But what you notice, this is 1 and this is 2. So from 1 and 2, what we notice? So from 1 and 2, A plus A transpose is nothing but A plus A transpose, the whole transpose. Okay, so that's how to verify. Find out A plus A transpose and its transpose, and both should be equal. So in such case, we will say that the given matrix is going to be symmetric. Now, to check the next one. They said A minus A transpose is skew symmetric. So what's the condition I should check? A minus A transpose should be equal to minus of A minus A transpose, the whole transpose. So first let us start by finding A minus A transpose. 1, 6, 5, 7, minus 1, 6, 5, 7. That's fine. So let us subtract these two matrix now. So it's going to be 0, minus 1. So 1 and this is going to be 0. Now the transpose of this matrix, whatever we have obtained, A minus A transpose, the whole transpose, 0, 1, minus 1, 0. The transpose of this matrix is written. Multiply the negative sign. So on multiplying the negative sign, A minus A transpose, the whole transpose equal to 0, minus 1, 1, 0. Correct? And what was our A minus A transpose? This is my A minus A transpose. And look at the matrix I got. These two are equal. So what's the conclusion I can draw now? So A minus A transpose equal to minus of A minus A transpose, the whole transpose. Therefore, A minus A transpose is going to be a skew symmetric matrix. So the next find, see the ninth one, for find half of A plus A transpose, then the next half of A minus A transpose. So a matrix is given there, right? For that matrix we have to find this. So what is the matrix is given to us? So it's going to be 0 A B, then this is minus A 0 C, then this is minus B 0, minus B minus C and 0. This is the matrix given, right? We have to find these two matrix. So first let us start by A plus A transpose. So what is A plus A transpose? First is 0 A B, minus A 0, then C, then minus B minus C 0, plus the transpose of this matrix 0 A B, minus A 0 C, then minus B minus C 0. That's fine. Let's add up these two matrix. So on adding these two, 0 plus 0 0, A minus A 0, then B minus B, it's going to be 0. Fine. Then similarly the next one. So on doing the next additions also, you can notice all the elements are going to be zeros. That's correct, right? Right. Then what is that half of this matrix? Half of A plus A transpose is also going to be a zero matrix, right? Then what if they say subtract? Quite simple. Instead of addition, we have to put the subtraction signs. So this time, will it be 0? No. 0 minus 0, 0. A minus of minus A, that's plus A. So this is going to be 2A. B minus of minus B, that is 2B. So what is it I'm going to get now? The next one is going to be minus 2A, 0, then 2C. The next one, minus 2B, minus 2C and 0. But we have to take half of this. So half of A minus A transpose equal to 0. Each element is multiplied by half. So 0 A B, then minus A 0 C, then minus B minus C 0. This is half of A minus A transpose. Okay, fine. Hope you are able to follow the things, students. So far every inquiry has been answered. We never said to anybody that no, we cannot answer, it's not possible for us to reply. No one has said this so far. All the team members of EduStrain are helping. Okay, whenever any doubts they are getting, so they might take some time, but definitely they are replying and clarifying your doubts. Okay, so I don't think things are going very hard. Things are actually going in a smooth way. So you people are watching video, preparing your notes and trying to learn. Okay, and even we are trying hard in the same fashion, so that the things we can do it in a simple way, so that it becomes easy for you to understand. Got? Okay, now an important one, the 10th one. There are 4 problems and I will do 1 and 2, 3 and 4 will be done by you people. Fine, so that you have to take it as assignment. So in the 10th main, first one, a matrix, they have not named it, so I'm going to name this. What they are telling is, given a matrix, express A as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric. So what is that I should do? Simply, I know this should be written as half of A plus A transpose and this should be written as half of A minus A transpose. So let us find these two separately and I'm going to add it. Right, on adding I should get back matrix A. So finding these two separately, that's my first thing. So first thing, so let us start with A plus A transpose, 3, 5, 1, minus 1, plus 3, 5, 1, minus 1. That's fine. So let's add up these two, 6, 6, 6, minus 2. Addition of these two matrix, correct. Take the half of this. Half of A plus A transpose equal to half of this. So 3, 3, 3 minus 1. Similarly, A minus A transpose equal to 3, 5, 1 minus 1 minus 3, 5, 1 minus 1. This time subtraction. So it's going to be 0, then the next 4 minus 4 and 0. Take the half of this now, half of A minus A transpose, 0, 2, minus 2, 0, right? So I will subtract, I see. First thing is when you are solving this form, no? It's better you write down in the beginning this formula, then start the things. So you'll get to know actually what you have to exactly find. So I'll substitute both the things here. So this matrix, this I got it as 3, 3, 3, minus 1, plus the second matrix I got it as 0, 2, minus 2, 0. So let's add up these two now. So I'm adding, so this is going to be 3, 5, 3, minus 2, that's 1. The next one is minus 1. And what is this, students? The one what I got here is nothing but my matrix A. It is the same thing what I have in the left hand side already. This is what should be done, right? So when they say express the matrix as sum of symmetric and scalar symmetric, what we have to find? Half of A plus A transpose. So to start with, first A plus A transpose and then half of that. Next A minus A transpose, then half of that. So after finding those two, substitute in this formula, simplify the matrix what you get here. This is nothing but your matrix A. That is what the proof is actually going to be, okay? So this I explained for a 2 cross 2 matrix, right? The same thing I will explain for a 3 cross 3. Procedure still remains the same. The only thing it's going to be a 3 cross 3 matrix this time. Fine? Okay, students. Now the same concept I'm going to explain for a 3 cross 3 matrix. So that's the second problem which I'm going to explain. So matrix A equal to 6, minus 2, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 1, 2, minus 1, 3. This is the matrix. So this should be expressed as sum of symmetric and scalar symmetric. So I should start with, so I always write the formula first, half of A plus A transpose plus half of A minus A transpose. So let's find the thing separately and add it. So let's start with A plus A transpose. So 6 minus 2, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 1, 2, minus 1, 3, plus its transpose, 6, 2, 2, then minus 2, 3, minus 1, 2, minus 1, 3. So let us take the addition of these two. So I'm adding this, so it's going to be 12 and minus 4, 4. Now the next, 0, 6, minus 2. Now the next one, it's going to be 0, then minus 2. Sorry, we're adding, right? Somewhere, I'm just going to cross check once again. So 2 plus 2, it's going to be 4. Minus 2 plus 2, 0, then 3 plus 3 is 6, minus 1, yeah, that's fine. So 2 plus 2, then minus 1, that's fine. So 2 plus 2 will be 4, yeah, I was going wrong here, right. The next one, 3 plus 3 is going to be 6. Take the half of this now. So half of A plus A transpose equal to 6 minus 2, 2, 0, 3, minus 1, 2, minus 1, 3. This is half of A plus A transpose. So similarly, let me start with A minus A transpose, correct? I have here, so I'll subtract it directly. Okay, I can save some space here. So that's going to be 0. Now the next one is 0, right? And the next one is 2 minus 2, that's also going to be 0. What's the next one? So on subtracting, so it's going to be minus 4, right? Yeah, the next one, 3 minus 3 is going to be 0, minus 1 plus 1, that's going to be 0. The next, 2 minus 2 will be 0, minus 1 plus 1, that's going to be 0. Then 3 minus 3, that's also going to be 0. Okay, fine. So this is, let us take the half of this. Half of A minus A transpose is going to be 0, 0, 0, minus 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. That's fine. Now what should I do finally? Add up these two matrix. So let me substitute in this condition now. So if I substitute, my first matrix is 6 minus 2, 2. The next 0, 3, minus 1. The next 2, minus 1, 3. Plus the second matrix, what I have here, 0, 0, 0, minus 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. The rest is addition of these two matrix, right? So let's add up these two matrix. So simply it's going to be 6 minus 2, 2, 0 minus 2, that's minus 2, 3, minus 1, 2, minus 1, 3. What I have here is nothing but the matrix what's being given to us. This is nothing but matrix. This is what we have to get exactly, right? So the problem is based on transpose. So mainly what are things we study? Properties on transpose. So we have A plus B the whole transpose, we have A minus B the whole transpose, then AB the whole transpose. Apart from this, we have something called as symmetric and skew symmetric. Okay, so symmetric if A equal to A transpose and skew symmetric if A equal to minus A transpose. Then every matrix can be expressed as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric. These are the topics which will be covered under transpose. Okay, so the last, there are two objectives, so I'm not going to touch the objectives right now. So it's okay. Anyway, we're going to study the same problems in objectives also. So we'll come back to those later when doing the objectives. So 10th main, two problems that I'm going to leave it for assignment. When I feel it's easy and almost all the students can do it, it's better if I just leave one or two problems for assignment. So please take it. Okay. The last and the most important thing is going to be based on something called as inverse of a matrix. We studied in relation functions, we have studied something called as inverse of a function. We have studied this thing, right? What was the condition there, inverse condition? So f of g should be equal to y and g of f should be equal to x. Okay, then we say that f inverse exists and f inverse equal to g, correct? Now similar to that, not exactly the same, I'm just trying to give a comparison. So in inverse function we have studied this, when to say one is inverse of the other function. Quite simple, these are the two conditions which has to be satisfied. Similarly, right now here also we're going to define what is called as inverse of a matrix. Student, inverse of a matrix, okay, we are studying in the chapter called as matrix. The same topic is there in the next chapter also, called determinants. The same topic, but here finding the inverse is different and here finding the inverse is different, but both the answers are same. So what my students will do, my 80% of the students, at least I will not say 90%, okay, at least I will say 80%, okay, okay, few students at least, if you know, okay, no sir, we are very clever, we will remember the concept. That's good if you remember. If not, there are chances these many students will interchange the method. Will interchange. What they will interchange? Now, what they will do here? Find the inverse of a matrix by using elementary transformation. That's one method. Find the inverse of the matrix using determinants. That's second method. This method is too easy for my students. Okay, so what they will do, they will skip this process. They will directly go for finding inverse by using determinants because that's easy. Answer is correct. But if you're interchanging the method, zero marks will be allotted. So you need to take care not to interchange the method of finding the inverse of a matrix. Okay, students? So how to define inverse of a matrix? It's simple definition is there. So if A is a square matrix of order m, you can say actually square matrix m cross m, that is what we have to write now, but normally when defining square matrix, order is just one letter because other letter is also the same, right? So if A is a square matrix of order m and there exists a square matrix B of same order. There exists a square matrix B of same order such that AB, that means product of A and B. See, A is the given matrix. You are finding there exists another matrix called as B such that AB is equal to BA is equal to I. If this condition is possible, then B is called inverse of A, denoted by B equal to A inverse. Okay, students?